God.
Yeah.
This is not true. Yeah. None of it's true.
Yeah, because, I mean, you know.
That's pure lie.
Yeah, it's just a bunch of hocus pocus.
Yeah, Christ doesn't care about any of that. Christ, yeah, Christ is real. Christ is existing.
Yeah, he's a forgiving spiritual teacher.
He is a forgiving spiritual teacher, but you don't have to have asked for forgiveness.
No,
you know, you maybe need to forgive yourself. If you think you need forgiveness, you got to forgive yourself.
Yeah, you got to forgive yourself. I mean, you know, because, like, you know, there's people that's never heard of Christianity, but there's also people that's heard of Christianity and said, no, that's not my thing. All right, but you're still not going to hell, or you need to forgive yourself. That's the same thing. Maybe one person just believes in Satanism, you know, or something like that.
They're not going to hell either.
They're not going to go get up next to Satan. You know? I don't know what that is, really, Satanism. But.
Same thing. Let's jump into that. That's another question. You just started that. What you just said goes into the next question that we got. Do pedophiles go to hell or anything like that? No.
No, there's no hell. There's no place for the pedophiles to burn or whatever.
Or anyone.
Whatever you think that they should go through out of
for what they did in this life. I mean, it's just no. They don't go to hell or any kind of punishment.
Yeah, it's like wishing more pain on causing pain. You know, you can be victorious with your justice and get them behind jail and stuff, but it doesn't change the fact that what they've done.
Doesn't change it. And punishing someone by throwing them some supposed burning lakes of fire with the Satan with the flapping tails and the horns, and that's a whole lie made up by humans to scare children and people and to submit it to the church and laws. That happened centuries, millennia ago, and the Bible has been manipulated over the years. Other religions sometimes talk about hell, and Islam, and even there's some Buddhist teachings about hell realms and stuff like that.
Yeah.
That's how you know that's not really correct.
It's more of a mind frame.
It's a mind frame.
Yeah.
Now, you can create an experience of being in hell, but you're doing it to yourself. You're punishing yourself. If you think about it, think you deserve to go to hell, but if you create your own reality, making that you're in hell, but it's not permanent. You might feel like you're there, but you're not there. It's just you imagine it.
It's more of a collective consciousness talk thing that you might go through because you felt that was what was going to happen or something. But, you know, you'll be in and out. You know?
Nobody's ever punished for anything. Let me say that. Breaking it all down, the clear as it is, no one is going to be punished no matter what they do. No one is.
Unfortunately, you know, most of the stuff that we look at negatively is natural that's been going on, you know, before we even had laws against it, you know, or words against it or anything, or thought anything bad of it at all. You know, and I hate to say that kind of thing. I'm not trying to be, you know, a negative person myself, but these things are definitely...
Well, good.
We got 7.
Yeah, it's always that.
But yeah, we definitely
we've had firsthand experience with people, pedophiles we've run into on the other side, and molesting priests we've seen. And one time we crossed over a nun. I did that one alone. I came across the spirit of a nun who was in a self-imposed exile dimension. But I found out looking back at her life, scanning it. With my mind, she had gotten pregnant, and then hid the pregnancy from the other nuns, and then killed the baby when it was born, strangled her baby, and threw it in the trash can in her bedroom, threw it out.
Yeah.
And then when she died, she rejected the portal because of her belief system, the Catholic belief system, that she's going to hell. Because she did a mortal sin, killing the baby.
Yeah, she was scared to go through with it,
but... walk her through the portal and say, look, it's not like it, you think it is. Time to go on through. And like Jeremy and I talked about how we crossed lost souls over, souls that are too scared to go through. I've seen priests that have molested children on the other side of the self-imposed exile dimensions. I've taken them through to where the higher spiritual dimensions, or Christ was there to forgive them and all of them to clean their energy. I've taken serial killers there.
Oh, and people say jump on this, and they'd be like, oh, that's horrible, this is horrible. But this is not horrible. This is what the Infinite wants. I mean,
the Infinite wants this done.
Yeah.
This he wants all his, its children and all parts of the Infinite wants them to come home.
Yeah.
To that, to the prime creator.
Yeah. It's almost like we're being recycled through sometimes, you know.
No one should be left behind, you know, no matter what they've done. That's why I always felt understanding the people who did bad things according to this society. I have compassion, a lot of people, for people in prisons, people who kill people, even child molesters and stuff like that, serial killers. I have compassion for them, too, and I've helped them cross over, too, from when they've been lost.
I mean, a can may be dirty, but it's still recyclable.
Yeah, they can be cleaned up, you know. It's like they can be washed and cleaned, their energy can be cleansed, and it is.
Come back around as another good, you know, whatever you consider good can.
Yeah, and I'm happy to do it. I'll take anybody through the portal. I've taken gangbangers through. Most of them tend to cross through. They seem to be comfortable going through, you know, but a lot of them, sometimes they're not. Like I mentioned this a lot. I've seen them hold back and then get lost in the self-imposed dimensions.
Right.
Then I've taken on through, taken some Crips through, taken some Bloods through, you know. I've done some of them, you know.
Oh, yeah.
Among others, other ones, I didn't know the gang. I think there were some Mexican gangs. Mm-hmm. I've done some of them.
Gangsters.
I've taken prisoners through, people who've been executed. I've taken, like, people who were electrocuted, electric chair, and all this stuff,
mm-hmm.
who got lost. I've taken some of them through to the other side.
That's right.
I've done it all, you know. I'll do it for anyone.
Right.
And I'm full, very clear on that, you know, and I keep doing it. I don't want anyone to get lost. It's not much fun to be in a self-imposed exile dimension.
And Matt does go with that. He keeps up getting people through the portal pretty often.
All the time. I watch the news, and like when I hear, every time I hear about someone dying or someone being murdered, execution, I always immediately check in on them, make sure they're getting through, you know, make sure they're all right. You know, just like I checked on Dot Safe the other day, immediately the day after he died, checking on him, you know, and he finally went through the portal. He finally got the help he needed. That's just one. There's many others.
That's right.
There's some guy, like, when I crossed over before with an 8-year-old kid who could see spirits. Friend Christy's son, you know, walking down the street, this little young black dude came to me, maybe he was in the 20s, you know, hat on, dark skin kind of, had tears rolling down his cheeks, you know. He lay lost. He was tired of his existence and where he was, lost and depressed. He had killed like 2 or 3 of his ex-girlfriends over in Essex Village in Richmond. It's around there. Then Popo pulled him over. Finally, he blew his head off with a shotgun in the car. And then he was just lost and scared to go through the portal. And then he finally came for help. They, you know, the other side that knows about me and Jeremy and words out.
Yeah.
He came for help, and I took him straight through. But he was the most gentle person I ever met. After he cleaned him up and cleansed his energy when he went through the portal, I could feel my back warming up sitting at Chrissy's house. And her son was like, well, the guy who killed his girlfriend is sitting behind me with his rubbing your shoulders and smiling and just being smiling and happy now. I could feel him just trying to show affection and love to me, you know, gratitude.
Yeah.
Coming from, he was really, felt so much better. Stuff like that keeps me going. Doing stuff and knowing that it helps people.
That's
but
right.
We're on our 20-minute limit here on this one. We got one more video to do. We'll be back in just a minute.
All right. Peace.